are busy down to the circle today.
Yes, we are.
Welcome back to Sister Circle Live. Our next guest is an actor and stand-up comedian who's been traveling the world, opening for D.L. Hughley since 2012.
Wow.
His comedy albums have reached the top of the charts, and he's headlined a sold-out comedy tour.
Now he's back on the road again with his advice from a blank boy.
Yes.
Stand-up tour. Please welcome comedian and former flubber guy, Clint Coley. I'm a fluffy guy.
What's going on?
How are you? I love this hug. How you doing?
I'm a hugger.
Yes. Welcome to the show.
How you doing?
We are fabulously well. Come on, Jays. I see how you're working it out.
The Jordan's going down.
Yes. So, you know, it's Get Summertime Fine Fitness Week here on Sister Circle Live.
Get Summertime Fine?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, yes. But you've made this transition. You look fantastic. Tell us about your transition.
So, so what happened was, you know, I liked being fat.
Okay.
You know, because I was healthy, but I liked being fat because women were calling me. Because women were,
okay.
Women were calling me Gerald LaVert. And,
okay. You know, gotcha.
I like that. Yeah.
Oh wow.
Yeah.
And then
I found out I had some diabetes issues, man. Mm-hmm. And you know, black people, we call it the sugar.
Yes.
And I immediately had to make a lifestyle change. And there was a girl I was dealing with at the time. She was like, Clint, I love you, and I'm not going to let you go out like this. And she's really big on eating well and taking care of yourself. So
that's good. Look at God.
Yeah. Look at God.
Look at you turning up.
Yeah, but I like fat Clint.
Clint is lit right there.
You know how like they got Big Luther and Little Luther.
Like everybody love Big Luther.
Yeah, nobody like this. Come on, man.
Yeah, you good though. We like this. You're gonna be here a while with this Clint.
Exactly.
And that's what's most important.
For sure.
So it's like all the funny people come from down to Philadelphia. It's you and then it's Kevin Hart.
Yeah, I'm better.
But you're better.
Ooh. No, I'm teasing. I'm teasing.
It's fine.
But I mean, if you think it's fine.
Well, my thing is, if you in a situation where if you're a comedian or a singer or whatever, you know, if you don't think you're the best, then why are you doing it?
Yes.
Well, you got to have high self-esteem.
Yeah, so, you know.
Speaking of high self-esteem, D.L. Hughley has a lot of high self-esteem.
he does
not have any problem telling people about his self-esteem
by
speaking his mind.
Absolutely.
Do you ever run into an issue because he's so outspoken about all the issues?
Every time. The thing is with DL, so you know, he don't hold back when
no,
he got
don't.
To say anything
no,
like
don't.
That. So people will sit there and be like, yo, Clint, man, yo. Because like, here's the thing. Like, I realize when you either you're connected to somebody who's a big star or something like that, like, people always like, yo, what's up with your man? What's up with your man? So every time DL say something crazy in the media, they like, yo, what's up with your man? I'm like, I ain't got nothing to do with that.
Right.
You know what
I mean?
But that he's somebody who has taken me under his wing and given me, you know, I mean, he's given me life in my career.
Like, right,
what he's done for me, I really, I'm speechless.
He's a good guy.
Yeah, he's a real good guy.
Good.
He's done a lot for me.
Now, let me ask you something, though.
Yes, ma'am.
Being a comedian kind of puts you in a responsibility of activism in
such a
way. Because a lot of comedians, they just, they use their platform to, you know, say what time it is.
Absolutely.
Do you ever feel like, you know, especially coming under a D.L. Hughley wing, do you ever feel like that was in part some of the reason why you wanted to be a comedian?
No, I actually wanted to be a comedian to get girls. I had nothing to do with being an activist, had nothing to do with trying to,
look,
here's the story. So there's this girl, her name is Asia,
right?
We were in college.
Mm-hmm.
And you know how like, when you like a guy, everything he says, everything he does is funny, right? So there was this guy named Sylvester, she liked him. He was a good friend of mine from high school.
Right.
I liked her, but she didn't like me back.
Mm-hmm.
And she would always be like, oh, Sylvester, you so funny. I'm like, yo, he's not funny. Like, so I was hating. So one day he's like, yo, I'm gonna go to the Laugh House in Philly. I'm gonna do open mic.
Yeah.
And I'm like, well, I'm gonna go to the Laugh House and I'm gonna do open mic too.
Okay. Oh.
He never showed up. I did. I get booed. And,
oh, okay. Dang, I thought it was gonna be a better story.
Nah. Right.
It gets crazier though. So actually, subsequently, I am the godfather of their love child.
Oh wow!
So talk about being in the friend zone, like. Yeah.
Wow, you really are.
I'm really in the friend zone. Yeah.
Oh my gosh! But they ended up getting together, so he won.
But they ain't together.
Well, he didn't know.
Well,
they're not together
child.
Now. Oh. And you know, that's another story.
Oh, okay.
But
that's another day.
Yeah. They ain't together though. And
right.
And then me and her want.
Sister
circle. I can't.
Right, but you got some explaining to do. Okay, you got
it's
some explaining
a circle,
to do.
It's a circle, but that looked like a square.
Yeah.
So we gotta be careful.
Right, so let's talk about, you got some explaining to do, okay? So we went down to your social media and some PSAs that we picked up from the Instagram. Okay. So you have some explaining to do. All right, are we ready?
All right.
Ladies, know what you wanna eat.
Yeah, I'm tired of going on dates. I'm tired, you know what? So the man's supposed to let the woman order first.
Right. Okay.
And I'm tired of going on dates and you don't know what you want. Now you got to order first and I can't order because you don't know what you want. And now it's taking 15, 20 minutes and I'm hungry.
Well, why she just can't be like, you go?
No, no, because then now you're going to judge me. So know what you want.
Right, Red Lobster is a quality date. It is.
It's sure enough for you.
My husband took me to Red Lobster. I was shaming him at first, but guess what? 17 years later, he won.
And here's the thing. So when I was
growing, have you tasted those biscuits?
It's the greatest. It's the greatest thing on earth.
Yes.
Greatest thing. So the thing is, I remember when I was growing up, my mom used to take us out. You know, and she used to be, you know, and I remember Red Lobster was like a quality. Like Red Lobster was dope.
Like, that was like Sizzler.
And I'm just like, why are we Sizzler? But I'm just trying to figure out when did Red Lobster become whack. So
it didn't. Beyonce made it hot again. Okay, ladies, before you say yes, make him take his hat off.
Yeah, so you know, I'm 32. Well, I'll be 32 in a couple weeks, and you know, a lot of guys don't have their hairline. I still do, thank God.
Nice.
You know, I want you to take your hat off.
Oh, so
to make sure that there's a hairline there.
Exactly.
Right.
Yeah,
see how it's gonna end up. Mm-hmm.
Absolutely.
Got it. Well, thank you so much for being here, Clint. We definitely appreciate your
time
today.
Thank you for having me.
Be sure to follow him at Clint Coley on the Instagram, where you can find the link for tickets to his hilarious comedy tour coming to a city near you.
Yes.
Let's give it up for Clint Coley, everybody.